Welcome to episode 3, the final installment of our Caribbean vlog with Viking Expeditions. Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. Holly went on a semi-submersible voyage, one of Viking's included excursions. While Holly was returning from her trip, I went on Viking Submarine. A full 22-minute dive excursion is available on our channel. Here's a 1.5-minute sample. The next day, with neither of us going ashore, we just enjoyed the relaxing Finsa Terrace before heading to specialty dining that evening. We woke the next day to watch another ship dock alongside. No matter the cruise line, I never get tired of ship spotting. We went on a walking tour that included the history of Puerto Rico and El Morro Fortress. Indigenous people called the island Borroquian. Rice's Fountain opened to commemorate the 500th anniversary of the New World. El Morro was built by Spain in the mid-16th century to protect Spanish interests in the New World. Over the following 240 years, fortifications would be added here and throughout the city. Spain would retain control of Puerto Rico into the late 19th century. In 1898, El Morro fell to American troops during the Spanish-American War, in which the United States objected to Spanish occupation in nearby Cuba. Since 1961, El Morro has been managed by the U.S. National Park Service as a museum. Thank you. on our second sea day, we participated in a weather balloon launch. After the launch, we watched the balloon's progress in Expedition Central.
Of course, we're going to continue to decrease as we go up through the atmosphere. One of the things that will change eventually, the atmosphere starts to change slightly. But what will be really cool is the orange line, which will be telling us when we've gone through clouds or not. So these changes in the humidity. For a cloud. Temperature is now below freezing at 19 Fahrenheit. So it's really getting quite chilly up there. And pressure is around 60% atmosphere.
Most nights, a member of the exploration team comes to the hide to tell stories of their experiences.
I'll begin, everyone. I know there are more people coming, but I actually have two stories. Because don't we all have more than one story?
Nikki's first story was how she ended up living in Alaska. What started out as a visit and a kayak trip to Skagway turned into her living there for 20 years. On her very first kayak trip, she recalled her encounters with bears, a wild moose that pooped on her tent, and a whale swimming next to her kayak during inclement weather. A whale she felt guided her to safety. Her second story was a sobering tale of an adventure in Africa while a member of the Peace Corps. A tale which began with her participation, along with her sponsor, in a local village's celebration of life funeral, and ended up with her attending the funeral of that same sponsor who died 2 weeks later in a massive bee sting attack.
Tours, these are wonderful animals to watch. They are the ones that are coming up probably the most often and also doing some of the most spectacular behaviors, 12 to 14 meters, and they can reach sizes of up to about 40 tons, with again the average being about 25 tons. So they really are quite large animals. They have a quite stocky body with a large dorsal hump. Over polar regions to the breeding grounds, they can be making about 10,000 kilometer round trips. Things like ships make a lot of noise. Not only that, military do a lot of sonar.
We hope you've enjoyed this video and the series. Please consider subscribing to our channel and clicking that thumbs up button. Thank you. Why not have a look through our Viking and other cruise line content on our channel right after this video? Thanks for watching.